Hey guys, Mitch here for Licklibrary.com and welcome to today's free guitar lesson video. In this video today, we're going to be talking about five slow blues guitar licks that actually sound good. Now, when we say something like five slow blues guitar licks that actually sound good, what do we really mean? Well, all I'm talking about here is relaxing slow blues licks that we can play on the guitar that are easy to play on the guitar and easy to play over a slow blues progression. Now, all five of these licks are going to be timestamped in the video for you guys to easily access. But just before we do, let's talk about a couple of things. Now, firstly, how can we get the best out of our guitar playing in a slow blues scenario? Well, for me, it comes down to those expressive qualities and techniques, our bends, our slides, and most importantly, that vibrato. It's like the DNA fingerprint of every blues guitar player or every guitar player on the planet, and it's a huge thing that we can take advantage of. But why does it sound great over a slow blues progression? Well, one, because it's quintessentially associated with blues guitar. These techniques are something that we hear in the style and in the genre over and over and over again. But two, we can use these qualities to get ourselves into a nice, comfortable, physical space in order to get the best out of our playing and make it sound as authentic as possible. But the other thing we need to quickly brush over here are the different sort of progressions that we can encounter within the genre. So let's jump right into that. Before we can actually play easy slow blues licks that sound good, we have to be aware of the progressions we're playing over. Now, when we think of blues and blues progressions, whether it be slow, fast, or mid-tempo, we associate them with being 1-4-5 progressions of 12 bar length. And we can have major blues, we can have minor blues. And when it comes to slow blues, we tend to see that minor blues being favored. And even when we think we're hearing a major style slow blues, it tends to be that it's actually a dominant progression. For example, what you heard me playing over in that performance was over a G7 progression, which means we're taking the best of both worlds of major and minor, that major third with the minor seven, which gives us that quintessential bluesy sound. Today we're going to be in the key of G, and we're going to be covering that G minor blues, which is just straight up minor, as well as the seventh feel dominant G blues. So without further ado, let's jump in to our first easy slow blues lick that actually sounds good. Okay, so lick number one, we're in the key of G7, and we're going to be playing over that dominant progression, as I say, with the major third and that minor seven. And that getting the perfect blend of those is really important here, as well as using those expressive techniques with the vibrato. And we're going to have this big sort of bend and a half here to get that vocal kind of quality and the best out of our bluesy sound that we can get. Let's hear the lick in real time. Let's break down what I'm doing here. Well, I'm starting on the ninth of our G. And then I'm heading to the root note there on the B string, 8th fret. And I'm using that vibrato just to sit nicely into the lick. I'm relaxing into the lick before we hit this bend and a half. We have this kind of overbend idea where I'm bending from this note here, from a D, which is 10 on our high E string, up to this F. But we get this. So let's just put those together so far. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick that again, and I'm just going to pick and bend up. But as I'm going to bend, I'm just going to linger on that D note before we bend up to the F note. Then I'm going to release that, but I'm kind of going to mute it with the right hand. And then we're going to just pick that 10th fret, and then the 8th fret on the high E. Then up to the 11th on our B string. And this is where we're going to just kind of push this in between. So we get that microtonal major minor third. And then I'm going to head back to that 8th fret B string for our root note with the vibrato. I'm going to pick it twice. And then I'm going to pick it again and hammer on to the 10th fret. And then I'm going to end the lick with the note that we started on here, that E note. And I like ending it there on that 6th note, that E note, just for a little bit of relative flavour. Let's hear it in real time with the track. Okay, so lick number two. We're still in that G7 progression, but this time we're looking to hit the turnaround on that 5 chord. And the lick sounds like this. All right, now let's just check out what I'm doing there. Well, I'm using some 7 triads, some 7th chord triads here. I'm starting on this F sharp, up to the G. I'm doing that twice. And then we're gonna be hitting that 5th chord. So if we imagine a D7 there, I'm gonna go like this. And all I'm doing there is grabbing that 5th on our G string, then to the high E string, vibrato. Okay, let's just put that together nice and slowly. The second half of this lick sounds like this. So how I'm starting that is here on the high E with our root note on the 3rd fret, followed by the 5th fret. And then we're going to head up to that 5th on our B. And we give that a little, well, almost a semitone bend. And then we're going to do this little grace slide up to the 6th and then straight back down to the 5th. And then we're going to head to our 3rd on the B, 5th on the B, up to 5th G. And then we're going to head back that 3rd on the B string for the 5th interval of our scale here. And we're going to pick that twice and use that expressive vibrato. And from there, we're going to head up to the 5th fret on the G string. Back to 3rd on the B string. And then we're going to head to this 3rd on our G. We're going to give that a pull for that microtonal in between the minor and major 3rd. And then we're going to head to our root on the 5th of the D. And then I'm going to end the lick on this 2nd fret, the 2nd fret of our D string, which is the lead in to our 4th chord, which is the C7. As we can see, no pun intended, that note is in this chord. Let's see how that sounds with the track in real time. Okay, lick number 3, we're now in this minor progression. We're gonna keep it in the key of G. But again, remember with all these licks, we can move this around. What I love in particular about this lick is that we get to use these expressive qualities that I was talking about there in our vibrato, slides, and bends to great effect without really having to move at all. We can stay in one position and get the best out of a really good slow blues lick. So let's see how it sounds. Now, let's break that down. What I'm doing here is I'm doing a grace slide up on the high E string, 9th fret to 10th fret. Same thing out from the 9th to the 8th. And then I'm gonna grab 11 on our B string. And then I'm gonna grab this 10th here and I'm gonna bend, semitone bend. And as I release that, We're going to release that bend down and we're going to get this kind of thing. So as I'm releasing the bend, I'm doing a grace slide up to the 11th and then back down to the 10th and then pulling that off to our root note there, 8 on our B. And then I'm just going to finish here with a bend on the 10th of our G. Full bend, kind of gradually up to that kind of full tone. And then we're going to grab the 8 on our B string again. Now here we can do a pick, hammer on, pull off from that 8th B, 11th B back to 8th B for our root. Or we can do a pick and then a pick again on that 11th and then pull that off back to the root note. But what we need is that vibrato. We need to get that on there, that expressive technique. As you can see there, I'm changing my vibrato up. I could go like this. Or if I wanted a little bit more slow and controlled, we can go for that clapping kind of thing. It's just a nice way of using the full minor scale and really getting the most out of those sort of singing notes within the scale. Very vocal, cool lick. Let's see how it sounds with the track in context. Okay, so lick number 4, we're gonna be staying in this minor progression, still in the key of G. Now this one's gonna be a nice lead in to that fourth chord. When we first hear the fourth chord within our 12 bar slow blues, we can do this nice lead in. And let's hear the lick and I'm gonna break it down and show you guys what we're doing over that chord. All right, well, we're actually starting that just before that fourth chord is heard. So we're starting here 3-6-B. Okay, nice and easy. And then we're gonna do a similar thing we did in lick number 3. And what we're gonna do here is do a little grace slide from the 4th to the 5th. And then the same thing again out from 4th to 3rd on the high E string. And then we're gonna just grab that 6 on our B before we head to this note here, 3rd on our B, and we're gonna give this a semitone bend, like so. It's gonna sound like this. We're gonna linger on that, and that's when we're gonna hear this E flat note. So we're actually playing that 6th interval within our G scale, but when we turn to the 4th chord, that note then becomes the minor 3rd of the C minor. Maybe a C minor 7. We're actually playing that note. We're playing that note within the bend, but then when we release, we end up playing the 5th interval within our G major scale. And to finish the lick, I'm gonna do this. So we have a grace slide sliding in from above on that 5th fret G string. From there, we're gonna pull it off to the 3rd. And then we're gonna pick and slide from the 5th on our G up to the 7th on our G. And I'm gonna linger here and pick this 6th on our B twice. And use that nice kind of Clapton-like vibrato here. It's a slow blues lick that actually sounds good whilst anticipating the changes, using those expressive techniques and qualities, and creating some ambiguity with that lingering on the minor 7 note. Let's hear it in the context with the track. Okay, so our 5th and final lick is gonna throw in some harmonic minor ideas for you guys. Now don't worry if you've never used this scale before, it's not too different, we're only really changing one note within the scale. But the reason for this being is that we have, as I said earlier, in a minor sense progression, we often get this kind of turnaround where we're using the 6th, 5, back to our 1. And in this particular progression that I'm using, that is our resolve. And then when the progression starts again, we're just going to be starting again on that same chord, our root note, that G minor 7. So what we end up with here with those chords is an E flat major 7, our D minor 7, back to our G minor 7. Believe it or not, this lick is heavily inspired by Prince, and it's something that I love to throw in for that harmonic minor flavour, and the lick sounds like this. Now, let's see what I'm doing here. Well, I'm starting here on the B string. I'm going to pick and hammer on 6 to 8, and I'm going to pull that off back to the 6th. And then I'm going to grab 8G, and then I'm going to linger on this 7th fret D string. Put some vibrato on. So we get that. And then we're going to get this, which is a pick and hammer on from the 5th to the 6th on our high E string. And then we're going to pick that again at the 6th and pull back off to the 5th. And then what we're going to do is grab 7 on our B string, which is our raised 7th harmonic minor note. And then we're going to play 7th fret G for our 5th note there within our scale. And to end, we have this. Going to be heading to that 10th B string, semitone bend, release, and pull off to our root note there, 8th on our B string. It's an easy lick, and the harmonic minor really gives it that exotic feel. So let's see how it sounds with the track. So there we have it, 5 easy slow blues guitar licks that actually sound good. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, be sure to like and subscribe to the channel to check out more videos in the future. But also, we do check those comment sections, so if there is any content or videos you'd like to see from us, do let us know. And be sure to head to licklibrary.com for a huge amount of lessons and playthroughs and breakdowns from lessons on your favorite artists and songs. You can even get one-to-one support, as well as the backing tracks that you heard today. So until next time, take care and all the best.